Welcome to this eLearn security training lesson on mapping the internal network. In this video, we are going to see some techniques that will help us map the internal network from a machine that we have previously exploited. During this video, we will see how to retrieve network information from the exploited machine, how to use the session we have in order to scan the network itself. Since we are not in the same network of the target, we cannot directly run port scans and tools like Nmap. From our terminal, we can see the IP address of the virtual network interface connected to our Hera Lab environment. If we check the IP address of the exploited machine, we can see that it belongs to a different network. Therefore, we are not able to directly communicate with the machine in this network. To prove it, let us run a simple Nmap scan against the IP address and see if we get any results. As expected, Nmap tells us that the machine is not up. As we will see during the video, thanks to pivoting techniques, we will be able to use the session on the exploited machine as pivot to the internal network. This will allow us to forward all the communication through the victim into the target network. Before doing this, let us see how to use the meterpreter session in order to get information about the network and the machines in it. The ifconfig command we ran before gave us an idea of the target network. Since we want more details, we'll open a shell on the victim and run the ipconfig command too. From the results, we can see that the machine is part of a Class C network, and that the default gateway is 10.10.10.1. Moreover, we can also see something very interesting in the last line. The default DNS server has an IP address that belongs to a different network. This means that there may be more than one network in the organization. We should make a note of this information in order to inspect it later. Let's now close the shell and go back into meterpreter. In the pillaging phase, you should have already gathered information about shares, user accounts, and so on. Therefore, we will now focus on how to discover further machines. One of the easiest ways to do this is by checking the ARP table of the victim. Thanks to Metasploit, we can easily do this by running the following command. As we can see, we now know the IP address of a few other machines in the network. Note them, since we will need these IP addresses later on. So far, we have discovered a few IP addresses without even sending a single packet to them. Another command we should run in order to have a better understanding of the network map is route. It can be used to display and modify the entries of the local IP routing table. Unfortunately, the command doesn't give us any further information on the network. Let's keep investigating the machine and see if we can gather information from the DNS cache. Let us open a shell on the machine and run the following command. As we can see, we discovered two domains, www.els.com and internal.els.com. Moreover, if we look at the A record, we can see an IP address that we didn't discover yet. Once again, it belongs to a different network, which is the same as the DNS server. From what we can understand so far, it seems that on the 10.10.11 subnet, there are a few servers running. That's very interesting, and we will surely check them later. The last thing we want to gather before actually scanning the network is the list of active connections and listening services on the machine. This may be useful, because it can reveal other hosts that we didn't discover so far. The command we're going to use is netstatit. Netstatit is a powerful built-in tool that displays active TCP connection ports on which the computer is listening, statistics, routing table, and much more. As we can see from the help manual, each one of these switches gives us specific information. The options we want to use are A, N, and O. With these switches set, we will see all the connection and listening ports, but also the processes ID associated to each entry. If we want even more details about the processes, you can also use the -B options. So let's run it and see what we obtain. As we can see from the output, the machine is listening on a few different ports, but it also has some current active connections. Of course, one of these is a meterpreter session to our machine. Although we didn't discover any new IP address, this command will give us a very good understanding of what the current machine is sending and receiving on the network. Thanks to the commands used so far, we were able to retrieve a good amount of information about the network and its machines. Although we could keep investigating files, application configurations, and so on, we will now focus on active techniques that will help us discover further hosts on the network. Metasploit already offers some scripts and modules to do so. The first one we're going to use is called Ping Sweep. It will just perform a ping sweep using the victim operating system ping command. Let us go back in the Metasploit console and select the module. The only options we have to set are the session on which the command will run and the IP address range to scan. So let us start the two parameters and run the module. As we can see, we have discovered some new IP addresses. As usual, remember to note this information since we will need it later on. The next script we're going to use is called ARPScanner. Since we can run it directly from our meterpreter session, let us interact with it and print the script help manual. This module will simply perform an ARP scan for a given IP range. We just need to specify the target address range. In our case, it will be the whole subnet where the target machine is attached. As we can see from the results, a new IP address is listed here. So far, we have discovered hosts and networks thanks to information gathered from the exploited machine, and thanks to Metasploit post-exploitation modules. Now it's time to investigate more of these new hosts. The best way to do so is by running a port scan. Although we have a session on the machine, we are on a different network. Therefore, we are not able to run tools like Nmap right now. In order to bypass this issue, we can use the exploited machine as a bridge and forward all the packets through it. In other words, the victim will work as a proxy between us and the remote network. In order to do this, we have a few different options. We can use proxy tools such as proxy chains and RedSox, but we can also use scanning modules that are available in Metasploit. Before actually configuring the pivoting environment, let us prove that right now we cannot scan the machines within the target network from Metasploit. Let us select the TCP port scan module and configure it in order to scan on the machines we have found in the previous steps. Let us set the remote host value to 10.10.10.7/32 and the port range from 20 to 200. From the information gathered before, we know that the target machine has a few services running within this port range. Let us also increment the threads to 20 and run the module. As we can see, the module returns no results. This happens because right now we cannot reach the machine itself. Let's now configure the pivoting environment and then run the module once again. The first step is to add a route to the target network. Let us select the AutoRoute module stored at the following path. As we can see from the available options, we need to set the session and the subnet we want to add. Let's use the subnet option with the target subnet 10.10.10.0 and then set the session ID. Once we run the module, Metasploit will redirect all the traffic destined to the subnet through the exploited machine. The route has been added. From this moment on, every time we try to run a module against one of the hosts in the subnet, the connection will go through our victim session. We can also verify that the route is working by running the route print command. Once again, this will instruct Metasploit to forward all the traffic destined to the subnet through the session number 1. Notice that this does not apply only on auxiliary modules. Exploits modules 2 can be executed through this route. Therefore, if we find any vulnerable application running on the network, we can use the route to exploit new machines. Let's go back to our port scan module and see if this time we get different results. As we can see, now we start getting some results. Here indeed, we can see a few open ports on the machine. Of course, we can now change our target IP address and scan any other machine in the network. Let us try to change the target IP address with the following and see if it works. Great, it's working. Thanks to the route and the port scanner module, we are now able to run basic TCP port scans against the machine in the target network. In the previous results, we saw that the machine at the address 200 has the port 22 open. This probably means that SSH is enabled. What we want to do now is to tweak a bit of our pivoting configuration in order to use external tools through the meterpreter session. This will allow us to run tools and commands such as Nmap, SSH, Telnet, FTP, web browser, and so on, via the session on the exploited machine. The only thing we have to do is to set up the target machine as proxy and forward all the traffic through SOX 4. To do so, we can use the following Metasploit module. As we can read from the module description, the module creates SOX 4 proxy that uses the routing table set in Metasploit. In other words, all the traffic that goes through the proxy will use the route added before. We can leave the default module settings and run it. Once the proxy is running, we have to use tools like ProxyChange or RedSox to redirect all the traffic through the proxy. Let's try to use ProxyChange and see how it works. The first thing to do is to edit the ProxyChange configuration file at the following path. The only configuration we have to set is the last line of the file. Here we instruct ProxyChange to use SOX4. Moreover, that the traffic should go through the local host address on port 1080, which is the port where the Metasploit proxy is listening. Let's save the file and see how to use ProxyChange. What we want to try is to establish a connection in the SSH server in the remote network. To do so, we need to type ProxyChange followed by the command we want to run, which in this case is the SSH command. In other words, if we want to run a command on an application through pivoting, we just need to prepend ProxyChange to do it. As we can see, it seems to be working. Indeed, after a few seconds, the server asks for the password. We already know the password for the SSH server, so we will simply type it in order to prove that the whole connection is working. Here we are. We're connected to the machine within the target network. Here we can see the current IP address. Once again, all the traffic is going through the session on our first victim. Let's also try to browse the web application hosted on the same target machine. This time, we will run our web browser with ProxyChange. So the command will be the following. Let us try to navigate the target IP address, see if we're able to establish a connection. Great, it works. And we're asked to type in the credentials to access the web application. Thanks to the SOX4 proxy, we're able to run almost any command and application through pivoting. Notice that if we want to access a specific service on the target network without running any proxy, we can still do it thanks to the port forwarding command. Let's go back into Metasploit and clean the pivoting configuration. So let us stop the SOX4 proxy with the following command, and let us also flush the routing table. Now we cannot reach the internal network anymore through pivoting, but let's suppose we want to browse once again the web application hosted on the host 10.10.10.200. The fastest way to do this is by adding a port forwarding rule between our local machine and the exploited box. So let us go back into Meterpreter and run the port forward command. As we can see, we can instruct Metasploit to follow a local port to a specific address and port in the remote network. So, if we want to browse the remote web application, we can add a rule like the following one. With this command, we are telling Metasploit to listen on our local port 8080 and to forward all the traffic received here to the port 80 on the remote host 10.10.10.200. Let us run the command and see what happens. As we can see, Metasploit tells us that the binding between our local address and the remote host has been created. In order to browse the remote web application, we just need to open our web browser and navigate the local address and port set. As we can see, we are once again on the web application hosted in the target network. In this video, we've seen some techniques and tools that allow us to map the internal network, but we've also seen how to pivot to communicate with a target internal network. Notice that there are many different ways to do so. We used ProxyChange, but we could have used other proxy tools such as RedSox or even create a VPN tunnel. We strongly suggest that you try them in order to understand how they work and what limits they have. Thanks for joining us.